your books to page 367, starting with Frederick the Great, King of Prussia, what would be considered modern-day Germany. He ruled from 1740 to 1786, the longest reign of any Prussian king, and, as his name suggests, he was perhaps the greatest ruler that Prussia had ever seen. Continuing along the Austrian
Emperor. Mr. Zollern, I want to learn more about Frederick the Great. There's hardly anything written here. What made him so great? How did he get there?
Well, that won't be necessary to know. I mean, he isn't even on our final exam, so it's not terribly important.
But Mr. Zollern, did you write your thesis on Frederick the Great?
I suppose I could set aside a little time if you're so curious. Where should I begin?
The beginning.
The very beginning. All right, let's see. Let's start when he was younger. Before he was the Great, Frederick was the 18-year-old crown prince, and his close friends called him Fritz. He had a sister who loved him very much, and a father who hated him very much. He wasn't married, but he had a lover, a man by the name of Lieutenant Hans Hermann von Katte.
He was in love with another man? That's gross.
Don't be homophobic. People can love what they want.
Exactly. I think it's sweet.
My thoughts precisely, however, at the time, people were not so accepting of this love. Fritz played the flute and had a teacher named Franz who gave him lessons in secret.
Why did they have to be secrets?
Because his father didn't approve. In fact, his father didn't approve of most everything Fritz liked. Learning French, reading poetry, he had to do it all in private.
Brilliant, Fritz. Wonderful job. I can see you've been practicing.
Well, every day, sir. At least the ones where I can manage.
A respectable feat, considering how busy your schedule must be.
Oh, it's actually not that bad.
Really?
No. It's horrible. My days are planned to the minute, per my father's request. The man keeps me on such a tight lead, it might as well be a noose.
Well, being crown prince certainly isn't a noose.
Oh, I never said it was, but then again, I never asked for it in the first place. Oh, my apologies.
I interrupted. Not at all, Lieutenant Katte. Fritz and I are merely making idle conversation.
I see all is well then. I guess the lieutenant. Is everything all right on the front?
Not on the level it's full to be seen,
my prince.
Thank you, Katte. We're very lucky to have you guarding us so that we may continue Fritz's flute lessons.
No trouble at all. Heaven knows what would happen if the king were to find out.
Oh, don't even suggest it. I mean, it's a miracle I was able to collect as many French books and garments as I have, much less have private flute lessons.
Miracle indeed.
In any case, thank you for checking in on us, Katte.
Of course.
A good man that Katte is.
The best. What? Well, what's that look for?
Nothing at all. Forgive me for saying this, but I've never quite understood your father's detestment of the French.
You and I both. What a gift to know what goes on in that man's mind. Oh, Mother says he and I are remarkably alike. Can you believe it?
I can't say I do.
Two souls have never been so different as my father and I. It's difficult to believe we share any blood at all. Oh, I could go on for hours about my father, how much he hates me, how I hate him. Never been privy to this quant, so thank God for that, but every chance he gets, he mocks me for everything I lack, belittles me in the worst ways possible. And should I try to rebuke, he flies into a rage, screaming of how much he hates me, what a terrible prince I am. You have no clue what I've suffered at his hand. And as if his venomous tongue wasn't enough, when I took my meals with him, he'd scant my servings and spit in my plate until it was inedible, then forbid the cooks from serving me anymore. I spent many nights going hungry. My sister, Wilhelmina, fares no better. As much as I hate what the king does to me, I would take it tenfold if it meant she were to be spared.
Has he struck you, Fritz?
Not yet, but I've made a sacred oath to myself. I will tolerate anything from the king except for blows.
And if it ever does come to that?
Well, I suppose I'd run away, but it won't ever come to that. Treacherous as the king is, he cares too much for the crown prince to have him injured.
The king is coming, but I thought he was due for another week.
Wait, it matters not. Quick, help me hide this.
Oh, there you are. Why didn't you answer the door when I called?
My apologies. I was just getting out of bed.
Mid-afternoon now. What are you, girl?
I was just a bit tired from training. But what brings you here? You weren't due to visit for another week.
I've never liked schedules. They're very limiting. I've come to inform you your sister, Federica Luisa, has been engaged to the Marquis of Anspach.
Wait, Luisa? Engaged? Just last month she had her 15th birthday.
And what of it? She is a woman now and must perform a woman's duty. I've been soft with her for far too long. It is time she learns the harsh reality of the world. And besides, I need more influence in that area.
You're marrying her off at 15 for influence?
I am, because I am her father and the king, and I do what is best for this country. You'll be receiving a regiment of soldiers from Anspach as well. Consider it a gift.
I'm very grateful. If this is all you've come to tell me, you need not stay.
Indeed, I do not. I'll see myself out. What is this?
Oh, nothing, sire.
Like hell it is. Voltaire?
Yes, sire.
What is the meaning of this?
Sire, I swear.
You swear what? You're a vile little cockroach smuggler who pitched contraband into my house? A diseased rat wreaking havoc in this household? A filthy mongrel asking for a beating? You're a heathen, a curse to this country. If I catch you with this kind of thing again, I will have your grubby hands cut at the wrist.
Your Highness, Fritz, my boy, are you all right?
My prince, go! Leave now. I said go!
Go right ahead.
never miss him. Lieutenant Katte, I mean, and I worry too. He isn't due to be back until next month. A lot can happen in that time. Come on, I'm just being silly. We should be talking about Louisa's wedding.
Weddings aren't talked about enough. Then, besides, the lieutenant's a strong man. Perhaps he'll be back in a week or two. You could catch up then.
You are a terrible liar.
Lieutenant Katte!
But you weren't to return until...
The general sent me home early after news of the wedding. A rather dull occasion, I'm afraid.
Dull as it may be,
it brought me home sooner. And now you two are stuck with me for 2 whole days before I get deployed again.
Wait, 2 days? That's hardly much time.
Don't worry, my prince. Come February, I'll be home for much longer.
That's wonderful to hear.
Well, now that the Katte's out of the bag, we'll be going on our way.
But I don't want to go back.
Well, that's too bad, because our dear friends here need to take some time for themselves.
So. So? You really miss me that much?
I'm pretty to hear that.
I know, and I feel guilty for eavesdropping, but it was nice to hear.
It was?
Yes, my friend, truth be told, I missed you as well.
You did?
Yes, it's lonely not having my best friend in my unit.
Right.
Is there something troubling you, my prince?
Marriage? Yes, it's never been something I've quite had to consider yet. It's always felt so far away and foreign to me, but with Louisa's wedding, I suddenly see it up close.
But do you not find it exciting?
Well, I'm unsure. I've read so much poetry that, to me, marriage feels like something that should be born in love, not status or wealth. It's naive, I know, but by getting married, you're dedicating your whole self to one other person for the rest of your life. What is that other than love, than romance, and yet we treat it like a business agreement?
I think that there's something romantic about making such an agreement.
How so?
It's more about trust.
You may not know the person very well or love them at all, but
you're making an agreement to better each other's lives as much as possible. And you're not blinded by
lustful
thoughts. So, in a way, you're more true.
So, you were saying love has nothing to do with it?
Not at all. Love has everything to do with it.
I don't follow.
Say that you have a partner on the battlefield.
I'm meeting my lover on the battlefield.
No, I suppose not, but think about it in terms of friendship. It's a bond built on trust, whatever on equal footing. You trust that you'll protect each other and always have each other's best interests in mind. Now that's the agreement part, but as the friendship grows, you not grow to care for each other. It's only a natural dynamic.
So, you're suggesting that I fall in love with a friend?
No. No. That was just a metaphor, a comparison.
You know, Katte, I never grow bored of hearing your insights.
Thank you, Your Highness.
Call me Fritz. It's as you said, we ought to be on equal footing in this agreement.
As you wish, Fritz.
Father, you wish to speak with me?
Yes, come in. This February, I'm to meet with the King of Poland.
A political meeting.
All meetings are political, Frederick, but this could be considered more of a retreat. The trip will last at least through the end of the month at a little camp in the countryside.
That's wonderful for you, Father.
And you'll be coming with me.
What?
You're becoming a man, and I see it fit that you begin to learn a thing or two about your position. Perhaps then, you won't be so useless on the
floor. Well, I'm sorry, I can't.
It wasn't a question.
It's just that February is when Lieutenant Katte gets back. I hardly ever get to see him as it is.
The lieutenant will have to wait then, because you're coming with me to Poland.
No!
What did he just say to me?
I'm not going. End of story.
Be wise to watch your tone with me, boy.
Lieutenant Katte is important to me, and I'm going to see him in February.
Why are you hung up on this Katte anyways? Don't tell me you've become amorously involved with this man.
Of course not. I care about him, that's all.
Lies! I can see it in your eyes! I always knew you were a sissy, but to think you'd besmirch your reputation with an act of sodomy—
No, it's not like that, Father!
You're a disgrace to the family!
Please, Father.
You may call me Father, but you're fit to be my son. You disgust me! I can barely look at you! How's it any minister for such a foul offspring? I'd call you a bastard if I didn't know any better.
No!
You got lucky this time, mongrel.
Should I fetch a doctor?
My friend, if necessary, I'll be fine. Leave me, please.
I've had to tolerate anything from him but blows.
That is what I told myself. I never thought it would actually happen. Yes, I'm the prince, but I'm also his son. But perhaps I was mistaken. Perhaps this is where I stop my tolerating.
Don't do anything stupid on a trip with Father. And Fritz.
For God's sake, take off that ridiculous outfit.
Countryside until now.
Ah, yes, my country is beautiful in the spring months, and I have arranged for you to have the most splendid lodging.
Have you a dollar kettle for this one as well?
Your wit has only sharpened with me. Now come, let me show you the accommodations.
Father, am I to accompany you?
What? Did you say something?
Never mind. There you have it, folks. Polish hospitality.
I've just never seen a man write so readily with a quill and ink outside.
These ones were made for travel.
I see. Have you ever considered using a pencil instead?
A what?
A pencil. They're particularly handy if you need to write things quickly, if I may.
See here? I can make marks with lead, no ink required.
The heavens? Where did you find this?
A friend of mine gifted them to me. As far as I know, they're only in England.
Well, you're English?
Born and raised.
A beautiful country. My uncle lives there.
Uncle? What's his name? Perhaps I know him.
You might. In any case, thank you for sharing this fascinating tool.
Keep it.
Are you sure?
You'll get much more use of it than I ever will. Deserves to be in the hands of a poet, such as yourself.
Oh, I'm not a poet.
That journal tells a different story.
Who are you?
Captain Guy Dickens, at your service. And you might be?
Frederick, but most people call me Fritz.
Well, it's a pleasure to meet you, Fritz.
Worries me.
Well, look who decided to join us.
Good evening.
Come sit, have a drink with us.
No, Frederick. You shall sit right here, front and center. Gentlemen, I present to you my son, the Crown Prince of Prussia, and a chicken-hearted sodomite. By my father, I would have blown my brains out. But this fellow, he has no honor. He takes all that comes. It looks like he needs a drink. Come on, my boy, and take a sip.
No!
It looks like someone has had too much wine. A toast to the Crown Prince, everyone.
Stop trying to pretend you respect me! You saw what happened in there. I'm only a prince by name.
That isn't true.
do respect you. I've heard much about you. About your achievements in battle. About your greatness.
The day I'm recognized as great will be the day hell freezes over.
I'm being truthful, Your Highness. You're a great man if I've ever met one. Even if your father doesn't think so. Even in just the short amount of time, I've grown rather fond of you.
Well,
I suppose I've grown rather fond of you as well. Wait, no, stop!
Forgive me, Your Highness, I thought...
You thought wrong.
So, you aren't... Well, yes, but don't get me wrong, Captain. You're very attractive and incredibly charming. It's just that... You're taken?
Not exactly.
Holding out for someone, then?
Something like that.
Don't worry. I understand. He must be quite the catch to caught the eye of the Crown Prince.
He is.
Forgive me for speaking out of turn and bringing this up, but your father, does he always treat you like that?
Day in, day out. C'est la vie of a Crown Prince, I'm afraid.
My deepest condolences. It's not something you deserve. If there's anything I can ever do to help, just say the word.
Be careful, Kai. I just might take you up on that offer.
Have you something in mind?
Well, I did. You see, I was planning to run away on this very trip.
Where would you have gone?
England, actually, to go and live with my uncle.
Your uncle, the king? God, I feel like such an idiot.
Don't be so hard on yourself, Captain. You didn't know.
Well, now I do. And, Your Highness, I must ask, with having such connections at your beck and call, why would you not go through with the plan?
Well, I was afraid of what would happen to my sister if I did.
Then go back for her.
What?
You're a Prussian army man, not to mention nephew to the king. You could easily scrounge up battalion soldiers, storm Berlin, and bring back your sister.
You think a mere battalion could go up against the Prussian army?
Probably not, but I could find you soldiers as well. Hell, it'd be good to knock that father of yours down a bit.
Or kill him.
That too.
It's like a Hamlet. Going on a journey, then returning to kill the corrupt ruler of your homeland.
Except the roles of uncle and father are reversed. Yes, something like that.
If the king is dead, I wouldn't have to go back for my sister at all. She'd be safe.
Also true.
Good God, Guy, you're a genius! I'm free, my sister's safe! It's perfect.
If we are to go through with this, it's paramount to begin planning now.
Well, then what are we waiting for?
This is ridiculous. You're gonna get us all killed and then some.
Not necessarily, if we play our cards right. You see, I'm a captain in the English army, and thus face no dangers of persecution in Prussia, unless they'd like to start a war. I've been in correspondence with the king,
my uncle,
and he's more than willing to aid Fritz in his escape and grant him English citizenship.
All right. Walk us through this, step by step. 2 weeks from now, my father will go on a journey to the Rhine, and I'm to accompany him, as per usual. One of our knights will be spent in Stuttgart, just a few miles from Strasbourg, and the border of France.
Once he sets foot on French land, he'll be safe from the law, and not from his father. Which is why you, Lieutenant Katte, are to meet him there, bring all his private papers and 1,000 ducats, and accompany him for the rest of the journey.
I am.
Katte,
I trust you more than anyone in the whole world. There's no one I'd rather make a mistake with, and I will lead you silent for as long as you shall have me.
Good Lord, get in bed already, would you, Ems? Hey, where am I supposed to fit in all of this?
You're going to be my page, as per usual.
You'll help me smuggle in the supplies that I need, plus prepare the horses for the night of departure.
Fritz, you haven't heard.
Heard what?
I'm not going to be your page for the trip. I got reassigned just yesterday.
Well, if you're not going to be my page, then who is?
I am!
Holy Mother of God, Robert, how long have you been hiding there?
The whole time.
Why didn't you say anything?
It's not my fault. I got here before you guys.
Why were you out in the middle of the night? You know what? Never mind. How much did you hear?
All of it? But it's okay. I can help.
How, pray tell, are you going to do that?
It's as Fritz said. I'm to be his page. And I can smuggle horses and supplies just as well as you can better.
It's not your confidence that I'm worried about. It's whether or not you can keep your mouth shut.
I won't tell a soul. Promise.
You must mean that, Robert. I mean, this could very well be the most dangerous thing you do in your whole life. You can't tell anyone, even if they have a knife to your throat. It isn't just your life on the line here. Do you understand?
You have my word, my prince.
Well, I guess that's settled. Sort of. I can likely meet you two down the road as long as I know the time and place.
I'll write to you both once I know what day we are to be in Strasbourg. The letters will be delivered to you as quick as possible.
I must say, Fritz, man of words might just work.
Oh, it's all thanks to God, really. I mean, I wouldn't have been able to do any of this without him.
I see.
You know, Peter, Robert, perhaps I can disclose even more of the details to you as I walk you back home.
But shouldn't we wait for... Oh, you are absolutely right. We are going now. We're going to be gone right now. We'll leave you two alone by yourself!
So? You're really going to go through with this? I'm not sure I have any other choice. With the way things are going right now, my father may very well have me killed before I see my 19th birthday.
I understand.
I meant what I said about being with you every step of the way. I fear you may grow weary of having such work thrust upon you.
It's not work. Not to me, not to you.
Casa. Until we meet again, my friend. Until then. Return to Berlin, fleeing Prussia. It is very possible that you may never see me again, and if that is the case, this letter is my way of saying goodbye. All my love, Fritz. To my dear Katte, it has been decided. 2 days before our return to Berlin, I will make my escape. I managed to smuggle a Frenchman's clothes with me for a disguise, so as to not be discovered. On that night, I will flee on horseback, and by the time the sun rises, Prussia will be a distant memory. And I hope, soon, I will see you again, my dearest Katte. all my love, Fritz. Addressed via Nuremberg. To my dearest Katte.
To my beloved Prince. I know we are not to see each other again until our rendezvous, but I felt as if I must tell you something before we are to meet. I eagerly await our meeting in Strasbourg. You just left, and I already miss you so terribly that I feel as if my heart is about to beat out of my chest just writing this down. God, the mere thought that your eyes are going to read this.
I can hardly think straight. Although I suppose that's a normal occurrence when you're involved. Normally, I'm seeming to propose intelligent Lieutenant Katte, and when you step into my mind, it gives me butterflies. No, butterflies is not the right word. They're airy, light, inconsequential in the long run. What I feel has a weight to it. It sits in the pit of my stomach and squeezes my chest, and suddenly it's like the whole world disappears. I can't even describe it. You're the only thing I know, the only thing I want to know. It's like nothing I've ever felt before. And I know, I love you. You are the only one I love, the only one I will ever love. And I swear, my prince, I will love you until the day I die. All my love, my heart and soul. Fritz, yours.
Seems like my son may not lack a backbone after all. He's going to attempt an escape on this very night.
What would you like me to do, sire?
Keep a close eye on him, and have your men find Lieutenant Katte and have him arrested for conspiracy. From the looks of this, he shouldn't be too far from here. It seems it won't be quiet tonight.
I prepared the horse just as you asked, Your Highness. The fleet is one mistake. Good, my satchel strapped on and ready to go. Just over here at the other end of the court. Well, well, well. What have we here? It's rather late, you know. You boys should be in bed before you catch cold.
Captain Rocco, Robert and I were just on a night walk to get some fresh air.
Isn't that right, Robert? Robert, you could have just as easily gone for a walk around the halls. Why go out of your way to pass by the stables? Unless, of course, you weren't really going for a walk.
Thank you, Rocco, but Robert and I really would like to get going.
Not so fast, Your Highness. You see, I received wind of a rumor you were planning to run away tonight.
Preposterous. I mean, why would I commit treason to my country?
I don't know. Why would you?
You're being ridiculous. Now, if you don't mind, Robert and I really should be getting
going. Hey!
What are you doing?
Relax, Your Highness. I won't hurt him, just as long as he tells me the truth.
Stop this at once!
My apologies, Your Highness, but I'm really not at liberty to be taking orders from you right now. Now tell me, Robert, what were you and the prince really doing out here?
Robert! Don't!
If you tell me the truth, I'll be kind enough to spare your life!
All right, it's true! My brother and the prince and Lieutenant Katte were plotting to escape to France and then defected.
You vile traitor!
Thank you for your cooperation, Robert. Lock him up for tonight. Come morning, there's someone else who would like to speak to the prince. I've apprehended him, Your Majesty. It was just as the letter said. He was attempting to escape.
Thank you, Captain. Bring him in. Ah, so you were still here, then. I thought that by this time you would have been in Paris.
You could have been there had I wished it.
Why did you attempt to escape?
I wished to escape because you did not treat me as a son, but as an abject slave.
You are a cowardly deserter, devoid of all feelings and honor.
Not as much honor as you have. I have only done that which I have heard you say 100 times you would do, and you have been treated as I have been.
Wait. Sir, please. You may kill me, but spare your son.
Bring my mongrel son to the dungeons. He is guilty of treason and must be punished as such.
Everyone else can look into them and see
the crown prince that they've killed. The time has come, boys. Take me so I may be free at last. What are we doing at the window? Are you having me take one last survey of my domain before I part? Dear old daddy.
My loyal subjects, we are here today to witness the death of a traitor. A death well deserved.
I'm waiting for, bring me down there already.
Bring forth the traitor, Hans Hermann von Katte.
What? Wait, no, Katte, this is a mistake. He is to be exiled, and I'm the one to be executed. Katte, my dear Katte, look at me! It's been a while, Fritz. There's been some sort of a mistake. Unhand me, I need to get down there!
As you may recall, it was going to be the crown prince executed, and Lieutenant Katte was to be banished. But no, that was too light a sentence, considering the crimes that they have committed. They must be punished accordingly.
Father! No, Father, let me take his place! Let me be the one to die! Forgive me, my dear Katte, in God's name, forgive me!
There is nothing to be forgiven. Death is sweet for a prince I love so well.
Throughout history, he became known as Frederick the Great.